Welcome to the PeopleSoft Campus Solutions PUM 26 highlight video. This is Susan Beidler, part of this product strategy team. For PUM 26 highlights, we'll cover the integration to student financial planning. We'll look at the address configuration options we're delivering, the financial aid updates, as well as student financial updates. And for the UK, updates to the regulatory areas of UCAS and HESA. Let's get started with the updates for the integration with student financial planning. This may be new to some of you, so let me introduce student financial planning, also known as SFP. This is our latest module to support the full breadth of financial aid functionality. This is a cloud-based module, but we've integrated it with Campus Solutions to give our current customers the advantage of moving to this new functionality when they're ready and having it work directly with Campus Solutions. We're also building the integration of student financial planning into our student cloud products. So we look at this as the future of Oracle's financial aid offering. We delivered a number of integration between SFP and Campus Solutions enhancements in PUM 26. Let's look at the new SFP integration setup. We've updated the student leave of absence message to include scheduled breaks data using the holiday definition provided in the setup. We've also updated the SAFI message processing to control reporting of dropped or withdrawn courses. We've identified ungraded course enrollments as not applicable to SAP. The process has also been updated to provide more flexibility when handling program changes, where the SFP program type changes within the same career. And finally, you have an options for including the prior academic year for summer term. To control which terms to send to SFP, we've added the maximum career term record attribute to the run control. We've also updated the load SFP reporting data process to handle multiple disbursement numbers within the same payment period. The most significant change for PUM 26 involves a new page, the financial data in SFP program plan. This change is so significant that you'll want to look for a separate video feature overview that our team has created to walk you through this new functionality. It includes the cross-reference of SFP disbursement return to lender messages to group line and customer account. Also offers a comprehensive view that provides greater efficiency to ensure SFP financial messages have been posted accurately for each student. There's also a new component called the SFP message validation, which is a reporting tool to alert customers of processing errors within the integration tables. Now let's move to enhancements for address configuration. This enhancement brings the Campus Solutions address controls into sync with what the HCM product has delivered. The enhanced global address configuration feature gives your organization control over how to display address fields by country. The new address formatting allows customers to configure country addresses for countries that aren't currently delivered. You can now select which address fields appear on the data entry pages in the classic style sheet. The design also enables you to configure address properties such as field length and to identify if a field is required. You can also add your own cross-validation logic if the existing validation isn't sufficient. Let's take a closer look at the entry and validation controls you can exert. You can now manage which fields are collected along with controls for each field, giving you the ability to add or remove an address field, as well as indicate other elements such as field order, label override, field length, and prompt controls. Note that in PUM 26, we're delivering this configuration and updates for the classic pages. We plan in PUM 27 to deliver the equivalent functionality for the fluid pages. And while we're on the topic of addresses, we wanted to give a heads up to our customers in the Netherlands that we plan to synchronize address records between Campus Solutions and PeopleSoft HCM for the 12 provinces that are supported for the Netherlands, as well as remove all the other codes. This will impact any addresses and other records, such as birth information and passport, that use the existing state or province codes for the Netherlands. You might want to see the documentation for a helpful list of tables which could be impacted. Ahead of the updates in PUM 27, we recommend that you review these key transactional records to determine whether data updates will be needed once the state code updates for the Netherlands are delivered. Financial aid updates are next. PUM 26 includes financial aid updates, starting with COD updates for 2022-2023 award year, delivered objects common to both direct loan and Pell Grant based on U.S. Department of Ed updates for that 2022-23 award year processing, as well as some improvements. Also, return of Title IV funds, changes align with the current Department of Ed Return to Title IV worksheet, effective from aid year 2022. We've updated the return detail page to remove Perkins loan and display an updated funds return order. We've added new labels to existing fields to accommodate the Return to Title IV order update, and added and modified record people code. In response to usability concerns, we've updated the pencil icon with an edit label on the Accept Decline Student Self-Service page to make the function of that button more obvious. We've also delivered PhysApp updates to enable reporting of the 2021-22 aid year data and apply for campus-based funds for the 23-24 aid year based on the latest guidelines. Next, for financial aid profile processing. We delivered the profile application pages for aid year 23-24 with the addition of three new fields you see listed here. Student financial updates are next. An enhancement for student financials in PUM 26 is the automatic sorting of the charge priority list, first by priority and then by tree node. We've added the 1098T BI Publisher PDF template for the 22 tax year. And also, in response to an Ideas Lab suggestion, we've modified the audit, validate, report, and run control with the option to check for 1098Ts which don't have any reportable information, no dollar amounts, no checkboxes to report, and set the validation status in the SF Tax Val Stat field to D, or do not report. So this hopefully will be a benefit to customers so that they don't have to have IT intervention to prevent the creation of those 1098T forms. Next, we look at the updates for the UK for the UCAS and HESA functionality. Updates for the UCAS process included data transfer, Phase 2 of the changes required to support the transition from the ODBC link interface to the XML link interface for transferring data to and from UCAS. We also delivered support for the 2023 apply cycle with modifications to the setup and the transaction pages, new fields, and updating existing fields. Let's look at HESA updates for PUM 26. To support beta testing for data futures return, we've updated the HESA extract compare, master sync, and create XML process. For the ITT return for 22-23, we've updated the return setup page, HESA fields and entity field setup, the create extract, and the create XML processes. You've heard me mention a response to Ideas Labs, and I wanted to highlight for our customers that this is a great new capability that we've introduced over the last several months. You can see the URL here to go in and look at the different modules under Campus Solutions suggest your ideas, vote or comment on other ideas that other customers have submitted. That gives us great insight as the strategy team into what's most important for our customer base, and it certainly feeds in to our roadmap and our plans for each PUM release. I'd like to take this opportunity to remind you of a number of resources that I think are very helpful for our campus solutions customers. First of all, on My Oracle Support, you have access to the update image homepage as well as all of the documentation related to campus solutions. There's also a link there to the videos that we produce for specific features or for a PUM image like this one. You also have a link there to the PeopleSoft information portal, which is one of the easiest ways to get access to all the content related to campus solutions. You have the relatively new Ideas Lab listed there as well, which we hope our customers will take full advantage of. You have the Hug site listed, which is another tremendous resource for our campus solutions customers, with all the content that you, as our customers, have provided for each other. And then finally, for our customers moving to the cloud, maybe using SFP or interested in the journey to the cloud, the Cloud Customer Connect site from Oracle is a good resource for you to investigate. Thank you for joining us in the Campus Solutions PUM Image 26 Highlights video, and we hope you'll join us in future PUM Image Highlights.